For some, it's about brand loyalty. For some, it's about aspiration. They're marketing and advertising different ways. But let me try and answer it as a kind of technical question, a little bit more as a technical question. So some of this comes down to the ways in which we think about computer systems. So generally, if you think about it this way, you have what we would call the hardware. Then on top of this, we have a special set of programs called the operating system. And on top of the operating system, you will have what's called applications, yeah? Now, all of those also have what we, broadly speaking, is a windowing system. So this is the ways in which they present themselves to you. This would be you. You would interact with a window, say. That window would interact with a word processing application, say. That word processing application would ask the underlying operating system to do certain things, like open a file, and that opening a file would make certain things happen on the hardware. So there's quite a long history of different operating systems. From the very first inception, you would have different operating systems which would run in different manufacturers' equipment. So IBM would have one, Honeywell would have another, ICL would have another, and all of those different systems would each have their own operating systems. So the BBC Micro had one, the Commodore 64 had another, and all of those would come and go. So they'd be closely kind of tied to the hardware. Historically, what's happened is they'd also, each of those manufacturers would offer a different way of presenting the computer. So they'd have different windowing systems. So originally, they would simply be command line. You'd type out a command line and something would happen. Macs and PCs as being two of the main competitors. At one point, through the early 80s, the big difference that people would speak about would be the windowing system difference. One was graphical, one had a desktop metaphor, the other didn't. With the advent of that sort of facility on Windows machines, that difference less clear. So a Windows 8 machine and a Macintosh interface uses icons, mice, drives in similar ways. But you still will have a religious separation between people about those. Each to each say they're done in slightly different ways. So today I think the real difference between them is that Apple still own and build the hardware that they put their operating system on. So they exist both as a software company and a hardware company. And it's only recently that Microsoft have even attempted to do that again. So the Microsoft Surface is the first time Microsoft has sought to do this. Why is that important? Well, it's important because what the operating system has to do is translate the application's needs into things for the computer, the hardware to do. And if you've built that hardware, you know how that hardware works. You can optimize in particular ways. If you don't, then you can't necessarily do that quite as smoothly and quite as efficiently. So detecting things happening in the hardware is more difficult if you haven't built it, because you're relying on other people building things. So that's why the operating systems in Macintoshes can actually make presumptions about the hardware and its use, and therefore build and optimize and contest it. So they've actually tested their systems with the actual hardware that they run on. Microsoft have a different orientation. Their operating system's installed in many manufacturers' hardware, and so they can't really test it on every single possible machine. So that means they're not as optimal at that point or smooth at that point, and they're relying on what's called device drivers being specifically installed for each device. So that would translate the operating system commands to the specifics of that hardware. That's why often you see when you're using a PC machine or a Microsoft machine, you will see a need to reinstall and update and change different drivers. Mostly those are invisible in the Macintosh because they're pretty much owned by Apple and installed by Apple and updated by Apple. The plus side of this is it feels nice and and more efficient. The downside of this is you've only got one machine that it runs on, and therefore you've got a kind of sealed unit, which means that Macintosh machines are often accused of being more expensive, because on a Windows and Windows type devices, you can run it on a range of hardware from high to low end, and you can optimize the price of the hardware down by running on that, whereas you don't have that range of hardware in quite the same way. I've used Macintoshes and Microsoft as the kind of classic divisions that people use. But if you actually go through the range of others, this separation down into different systems also applies. So in terms of Linux, Linux roots are from original open source Unix. People have taken the kind of original Unix platform and ported it, made it work on a PC environments and sets of PCs environments, and so that operating system is capable of running across a wide range of hardware, and also there is a number of windowing systems that it itself supports. Now the advantage with Linux environments is Linux environments are open, so no corporation or company owns them in quite the same way. They're open source, they're modifiable by people, and people can moderate them and use them. So it's championed as one of the classic championing one of the biggest forces for keeping the internet and computer systems open and accessible to all.
Floating point looks at 1/10 plus 2/10, what you just typed in, 0.1 plus 0.2 in decimal, and it says that 1/10 plus 2/10 does not quite equal 3/10, because to its mind, it doesn't.